He is the ultimate insider, top RSS ideologue who's been playing the role of an interlocutor between the RSS, Nitin Gadkari and BJP. I want to go across live and exclusive to Chennai. Joining us from there is S. Gurumurthy, who's been mediating on behalf of the RSS with Mr. Nitin Gadkari and the BJP. This is his first television interview. You've been playing a pivotal role in trying to resolve this crisis. It was the Gurumurthy fact-finding committee, the one-man army, that gave a clean chit to Nitin Gadkari. And I have five questions to the ultimate insider, and we'll take this one by one. Question number one, Mr. Gurumurthy, how are you so sure that Nitin Gadkari is innocent? Given all the facts that have emerged in the public domain, you've done your own investigation. How is Gurumurthy so sure that Nitin Gadkari has done no wrong, Mr. Gurumurthy?
You see, most people, and I would say that the media has been not so careful about how to investigate this matter, because this is an area of my specialization. I can say with authority that Nitin Gadkari is managing a company in which X has made an investment, and that investment was made in the year 2001 to 2003, and the amount of investment was 47 crores. And this investment was made in the name of 12 companies, and these 12 companies belonged to a very important business family of Nagpur. Their family members were shareholders, directors, and this investment was accepted as genuine, and this is the only money that went into Purthi company.
No, but there is and a question, Mr. Gurumurthy, of tax evasion, about money laundering, about fake directors. These are very, very serious charges that have been leveled against the BJP president. What's your basis for holding him innocent?
Please wait. Yes. I am coming to that later. First, there were two parts to this entire investment. These 12 companies which originally made the investment in the year 2001 to 2003 in Purthi Group, these 12 companies are not questioned at all. They were accepted as genuine. They belonged to an important industrial and business family in Nagpur, and these investments continued till 2010, when that group shuffled the investment from these 12 companies to another 14 companies of theirs. This is very important. These are the 14 companies which are questioned, where there are the companies are shell companies and they have layers and layers of holding. And that has nothing to do with the Purthi Group, except that the shares of these 12 companies were transferred to those 14 companies. The question is, who are the owners of those 14 companies? The group which transferred the shares to those 14 companies has accepted the ownership of the 14 companies. I had a discussion with them. I asked them, as a seller, you should know to whom you are selling. And they said, sir, it is our own company.
No, but what about the fact that they listed out addresses of, you know, at places where companies were not registered? You know, the BJP and Mr. Gadkari have been taking the line that these are standard Indian business practices. But is that acceptable, Mr. Gurumurthy, to have, you know, your driver as a director, to have addresses listed, and when we go to those addresses with our cameras, it turns out that that company is not registered? Are these acceptable practices, sir?
I agree with you that if Nitin Gadkari has done this, he cannot take the position that this is an acceptable practice. But if the group which has invested in that Purthi Group, if they are doing it, and with which Nitin has no other relationship, you know, that group is an important group, and the name of the group, everyone knows today, it is the Mehta Group.
No, but and Mr. Gurumurthy, you are saying that there is no relationship. Can I just point out to you, hear me out for a moment, you know, the investment by 18 shell companies was the handiwork of Maharashtra businessman Manish Mehta, who put 47 crores in the Purthi Group. Now, it turns out that there is a twist, sir. Nitin Gadkari served as an independent director in the Chintamani Group, which is run by Manish Mehta. There is a close relationship between the two.
You must
sort of
understand, in these 14 companies, to which shares were transferred by the 12 companies of the Mehta Group, these 14 companies have a questionable structure. This is the most important point.
Yes.
But tell me whether any money has come into Purti Group from these 14 companies. No. Yes or no?
No, I don't know the answer to any those money questions. Has come That's something Purti which is being probed by the Income Tax Department.
As a professional, I need to tell you what is the relationship between these 14 companies and Purti Group.
Okay.
The 12 companies which invested in Purti Group are genuine companies. The 14 companies to which these investments were transferred by the Mehta Group, they are questionable companies. And Mehta Group has to explain who are the buyers. And if I am running a company and one set of shareholders transfer their shares to another set of shareholders, I cannot go and control them.
Okay.
In fact, normally what happens, a person who holds substantial shares, he has to appoint representatives to attend the general meeting. When that person is not in the management, he actually asks the management, please depute your representatives as directors so that we will nominate them as nominees under section 187 of the Companies Act.
Okay.
That is how Nitin Gadkari's nominees were there in those companies.
Okay, Mr. Gurumurthy. You are saying that the companies that invested in Nitin Gadkari's firm, their structures were questionable. I have five questions for you. I have put out the first question. I now want to take the second question for our viewers. Can Gurumurthy's independent probe be trusted, given the fact that you're a RSS ideologue? You are clearly a player with a vested interest. Yes, you're a chartered accountant.
Understand one thing. The media says I am an RSS ideologue. I don't become one.
No, but you have close and abiding relations with various people in the Sangh Parivar, whether in the RSS or the BJP. The question I'm asking, Mr. Gurumurthy, is can your probe be investigated? This is not Justice Verma, Justice Sodhi, somebody completely independent doing a probe. This is somebody who's part of the system who's done this investigation.
I tell you one thing. If I don't have the credibility to talk on this subject, I would never have gone into it. And it is something which I got into it accidentally. Nobody asked me to do it. When I found that these press reports were coming, I asked some of the people close to Nitin Gadkari, what is happening? Then last Wednesday, Nitin Gadkari has sent his accountants to me. When they briefed me, I found that there were two situations. The original investment of 47 crores was genuine, and the Income Tax Department investigated this matter in the year 2006 and accepted it as genuine. So there was no problem till 2010. In 2010, these 12 companies transferred their shares to 14 companies, and those 14 companies have layers and layers of structures with questionable officers, questionable directors. In this, I said, I have to talk to Mr. Mehta. When I spoke to Mr. Mehta, two things became evident. He said these are their companies. One, I said, are you saying today they are your companies? No, sir. We have disclosed these companies as our companies in the year 2003 itself to IREDA, to which Manish Mehta substituted 11 of the 14 companies to give guarantees on his behalf. And next year in 2004, he substituted three more of the 14 companies, completing the list of 14 companies, as companies which will give guarantees on his behalf. Which means what? It is Mehta Group companies.
No, but you met and Mr. Ram Jethmalani yesterday, Mr. Gurumurthy. You met Mr. Ram Jethmalani. I was there at his house when that meeting took place. Mr. Jethmalani is not buying your arguments. This morning he said, he stands by his charges despite your presentation to him. He's not convinced.
You see, Jethmalani told me yesterday, today I take you as true. And when I come and I see the documents, then I give me answer. He has not yet seen the document. And what Ram Jethmalani has spoken in the morning, I don't know. If he has spoken like this, then I will have to show him the document and say what it is, because I have seen the document. There is an agreement of March 2003 between EREDA and Purti Group, in which the guarantors' names are listed. Manish Mehta's name, which was to be the original guarantor, has been substituted by 11 of the 14 companies to give guarantees on his behalf. Meaning what?
But even Mr. Lal Krishna Advani is not very convinced, it seems, because he skipped the core committee meeting yesterday. He wasn't there. So it seems the Gurumurthy findings have not been accepted by the party patriarch either.
You see, I am not interested in whether somebody accepts my finding or not, because I told Advaniji, Advaniji accepted the truth of the thing. But Advaniji, in my understanding, what I was told was that Advaniji, having heard me in the morning, he said the same thing is going to happen in the evening. So, why should he hear the same? 1.5 hours I was with him in the morning.
Okay.
And I was doing the same thing. No decision was being taken in my presence. They only told me, you brief what is your finding. I told them that these 14 companies have not put 1 rupee into Purti. These 14 companies have purchased the shares of 12 companies of Mehta Group and paid 40% of the amount. Maybe 60% of these losses were claimed by the Mehta Group.
Okay.
And this 40% money which they paid has gone to Mehta Group. It has not come to Purti.
Okay, I want to come
now.
How do
you say there is any money laundering?
Mr.
You see, as a professional, I have to be true. And I would like to tell the truth to the media. Basically, these 14 companies have nothing to do with money or proprietorship with Nitin Gadkari.
Okay, Mr. Gurumurthy, I want to come now to the third question that we are going to ask you. We've got 5 questions. I said I want to come to the third big question. Why has the RSS made Gadkari's continuance a matter of prestige? Because we've seen in the past when charges were leveled against Mr. Lal Krishna Advani in the Hawala Diaries case, he took moral responsibility steps, stepped aside, said, let an independent probe be conducted, let my name be cleared, only then will I take public office. Why is Nitin Gadkari not living up to that high standard which is expected from a party which claims to be a party with a difference, Mr. Gurumurthy?
I'll tell you first one thing. L.K. Advani resigned when a charge sheet was filed, not when a media made a report. Today the media makes a report and I find the report totally wrong. I can understand if these 14 companies are putting money in Purti. If these 14 companies which are questioned companies had put money in Purti, then Nitin Gadkari has a moral responsibility. If Mehta Group sells the shares to these 14 companies and receives money from these 14 companies and declares these 14 companies as belonging to them, there is a moral responsibility for Nitin Gadkari.
But at a time when and the BJP has made the issue of corruption, Mr. Gurumurthy,
one minute.
Yes, please.
High standards of moral responsibility comes when a truth is established and you don't respect the truth.
No, but at a time when the BJP...
When was he established?
At the time when the BJP has made corruption its primary plank against the Congress, when the party president is accused of serious fraud and a probe is underway, would it not behove the party and serve its interests better if Nitin Gadkari stepped aside and, as Ram Jethmalani says, came out smelling
fraud
of roses later if the charges were proven wrong? You're saying this right now, Mr. Gurumurthy. If an independent probe also establishes it, wouldn't Mr. Gadkari's stature go up that much more?
I will tell you one thing. All that, whether Gadkari should continue or not, whether Gadkari should be the future president or not, is none of my issue. All that I wanted to say is that the media had projected as if these 14 companies had put in money in Purti, and this is money laundering, which is completely false.
But is it not a fact, Mr. Gurumurthy, that Nitin Gadkari is staying on as BJP president because of his close proximity to the top brass at RSS?
You must also...
It's because of his proximity at Nagpur.
Your next question must... Your next question must succeed the answer to your previous question.
True.
I am answering your previous question.
Yes, please.
I am saying that if there is a prima facie charge established on investigation, then Nitin ji must respect it. There is no investigation yet and a prima facie charge. Except that the media has thrown charges and I am finding fault with those charges. I am saying the charges are not correct.
Okay. I now want to come to my fourth question. This is about whether an insider was responsible for the leaks and whether part of the reason that Nitin Gadkari is staying on is that the RSS believes that there was a BJP insider who was responsible for the leaks against Mr. Gadkari. Is that not a fact, Mr. Gurumurthy? And I hope you'll be candid, you'll be frank, and you'll tell us what is the truth.
Actually, I'll tell you, I will never speak unless I know a fact. If somebody talks something in the street and I begin talking, then there will be no difference between me and others. In Delhi, everybody talks ill of everybody else. And you know, I am in Chennai. I am brought up in a very different culture. Unless it is known to me, I will never approve of or accept a suggestion that something like that has happened.
Okay, let me come then to my final question. Is Nitin Gadkari's second term as BJP president now out of the question as a consequence of the charges that have been put against him? Also because of the perception that's now been created that he's the BJP's biggest liability, does that mean that the BJP cannot afford to have the tainted Nitin Gadkari as its president, Mr. Gurumurthy?
Mr. Kanwal, you know, you are addressing this question to totally a wrong man.
I am addressing it to absolutely the right person who understands the RSS, the BJP equation better than anyone else.
No, I tell you one thing. I am not a player. You must understand.
You are the mastermind, the strategist.
If somebody asks for my... Listen, you must, you see, you have asked your question, I must answer it. No, you cannot push question number 5A. I am saying, if somebody asks for my opinion, I will give an opinion.
I am asking for
you
for your opinion.
The right person asks, one to one. I am not going to give an opinion over the national hookup and as an answer to your question for millions of people to view. I have a certain responsibility. And that responsibility I will discharge, not unasked. This one. Number two, your question is loaded with suggestions, assumptions that Nitin Gadkari has become the biggest liability. Media reports can make anybody a liability today because there is no verification of the reports. Previously, if one media takes a position, another media used to verify the report. Now there is a herd mentality. Everybody has to do the same thing. So, I believe the character of the media has changed in the last 10 years. And the instant media is one of the most important factors in this.
But
and
Mr. Gurumurthy, is it not a fact?
Today.
You know, given the fact that Ashok Chavan took moral responsibility, Shashi Tharoor took moral responsibility and stepped aside from their post, while the charges were not proven, the reason that Nitin Gadkari stays on is because Mr. Mohan Bhagwat has made this a matter of prestige. Because he installed Gadkari as BJP president, therefore he cannot be seen to sacrifice Nitin Gadkari because that would erode the moral responsibility, the moral authority of the RSS. Is that not what it comes down to?
I will answer it in two parts.
Yes, please.
So far as Ashok Chavan and Shashi Tharoor are concerned, it is not on media reports. It's on investigation. Today, you have only media reports and I am questioning those reports.
Okay.
And I am giving you, the media said these 14 companies have laundered money into Purthi. Completely false. Let us assume there is some truth in it.
Okay.
Then what you say may be correct. I tell you, nobody, including L.K. Advani, nobody has resigned or is needed to resign on a media charge. The media charge is certainly relevant for someone to come out with a reply. Advani ji resigned on charge sheet.
Okay.
Ashok Chavan resigned on CBI investigation. There is an FIR. CBI was investigating.
But that's much later. He resigned much earlier. He resigned much earlier. I'm afraid I'm completely...
Hello.
Yes.
Agreed.
He resigned much earlier. The charge sheet came much later. I'm out of time, Mr. Gurumurthy. Very quickly, final comment.
Today, where is the investigation against Nitin Gadkari?
Well,
and
the SFIO...
Nitin Gadkari has asked for a voluntary...
And the Income Tax Department are investigating.
There is no investigation against him.
Okay. I'll let that be the final word,
so,
Mr. Gurumurthy.
Another thing I tell you. So far as the RSS is concerned...
Okay.
You better... Because this is a loaded question. So-and-so wants it this way. So-and-so's authority is needed. Where do you get all these facts?
Well, anyway, you're the ultimate insider.
And I have to answer to your impressions.
And you've spoken out for the first time. You've laid the facts out in the public domain. People will now make of it what they will. They've heard from S. Gurumurthy from the first time. You've played a crucial role. You've come out and spoken to us, Mr. Gurumurthy. Thank you very much. Really appreciate your time and you speaking to us.